next bout of the evening is a middleweight K-1 contest to be held at three-minute rounds. Now making his way to the octagon, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Himmel Martial Arts, please put your hands together for Jamie Hopcraft. His opponent this evening making his way into the octagon, fighting out of the red corner, representing Lions Pride of London. Please put your hands together for Siddhartha Chowdhury. This is a middleweight K-1 bout to be contested over three-minute rounds.
Right, so we have middleweight K-1 over three-minute rounds of action. Jamie Hopcraft from Himmel Martial Arts, Siddhartha Chowdhury from Lions Pride. And as you mentioned, as we looked up, a goodly size difference between the two men.
Yeah, I think there's going to be a bit of reach advantage going to Chowdhury in this fight. Let's see if he puts it to good use.
Well, I've seen Hopcraft fight on a number of occasions, and he's powerful. He's an all-action fighter. He's suited to K1. He loves to come forward, and immediately an exchange of low kicks that are both blocked.
Yeah, a lot of parrying with the hands early from Hopcraft, a lot of pouring, but those low kicks coming in fairly thunderously from Chowdhury now.
And this is what you like to see, the kicks low, the hands high, and again, just want to take the, you can take the leg and sweep if it's immediate, and you can clinch and knee if it's immediate, then you have to release, but you can immediately tie up again. A lot of people think that in K1 you come in, clinch, do the big knee, and then pull away. If you're sensible, you just got to let the clinch go. You're allowed to clinch up again, so you can get two or three knees away.
Yeah, it's always something that you see from more experienced fighters, is just that awareness of what rule set am I in, what environment I am. And that's always the sign of a competent and experienced fighter, that when they can put those combinations together like that.
Well, Hopcraft just shook off a kick to the groin there. It was accidentally, it was going for the inside of the thigh, but it was the groin. But this is where Hopcraft likes to be. Although he often looks under pressure, he does like a tear-up.
Yeah, he's doing a good job of landing a few shots on Chowdhury. When Chowdhury throws those low kicks, he does leave his upper body a bit exposed, not bringing that hand forward to create the guard.
And again, a chopping right leg kick, left hand combination from Chowdhury. And it's a good move. But Hopcraft, as if you've noticed, is trying to take the center of the ring there and push forward, because aggression is key in K1.
Yeah, he's got a lot greater head movement of the two now. Both guys landing a few good shots to the chin.
Yes, lead left hook there from Hopcraft is landing, but Chowdhury brings that right hand up from the waist. It's not pretty, but he's a powerful man.
Yeah, can be surprisingly effective throwing from the hip like that. And of course, if you do bring your hands down like that, you actually have a greater degree of head movement needed there, perhaps, as he hits a right hand from Hopcraft.
Well, they're happy to stand and trade, which the crowd are enjoying, and they're just beginning to step up the tempo as well. They've had a look at each other, and as is the case with K1, they're stepping it up now and putting just that bit more into it, planting their feet, as we say, for these bombs.
Yeah, it's really nice to see both guys stay inside that range. You know, yes, they're breaking and creating a bit of space, but they're coming straight back in, sitting back in the pocket, and both guys throwing very well here.
That's right. The first, well, he turned that knee into a kick attempt because he was just out of range there. But as I said, I've seen Hopcraft before. He can keep this pace up for three rounds. He likes this. He will certainly pick it up in the second. Nice right hand from him as well. We'll see if Chowdhury can match him for that.
Well, those counter punches to Chowdhury's kicks are really what's helping Hopcraft in this first round here.
Well, the danger for Chowdhury, having had a good look at both men, is that he throws his heavy hooks from the waist, as you saw there, which will leave that head very exposed.
Yeah, every time he throws a kick, the hands just, the guard isn't quite there. Hopcraft's coming straight down the middle, landing a good solid right hand on the chin.
That said, I don't know about you, but for me personally, a tough round to judge. They stood there in the middle and exchanged kicks and punches pretty evenly.
Yeah, for certain. Could be a very even round for the judges. Potential for a 10-10 perhaps.
So round two or three, and we've both got it pretty even here. They will step it up though.
Chowdhury is bringing his guard back up now. He knows he was leaving his head open a bit. We can see when he throws those kicks, the hands come right down by his waist.
And there was the perfect example of that. Hopcroft again, though, as I said, is the man trying to push forward, taking the centre of the cage, trying to push forward. Good knee, though, from Chowdhury, but I still worry, Josh, about the way he throws those punches.
Yeah, every time those hands come down or every time he throws a kick, the chin is straight up in the air. He needs to be bringing those hands up, hiding his jaw behind his shoulder line. Otherwise, Hopcraft's going to just keep finding that target.
Well, you saw for the first time in this fight, Hopcraft slipped and then came over with the overhand right almost as a bolo. And when your hands are down low like that, that bolo will land. Good low kick attempt though again from Chowdhury, and both these men are using all the tools, up and down, low with the legs, bringing the hands up high afterwards. But this is where I think Hopcraft needs that booming low kick, then bring the overhand right.
It's the first time we've seen Chowdhury step through and attack the rear leg.
Yes, and a spinning back fist attempt as well. But again, as you said, nice subtle kick there again from Chowdhury.
I'd like to see a bit more head movement from the man in the red corner, standing a bit too upright and straight on each of these combinations for my liking.
But it is the same problem we've got as in the first. It's a well-made match. These two men are well-matched. It's good matchmaking, and it's a very close fight.
Oh, yeah, that's absolutely right. Both guys are finding the target. They're both pushing forward. It's a lot of back and forth. Extremely entertaining fight for the crowd here.
Chowdhury saw that just at the last second, went to grab the foot, which is allowed to do, sweep the other leg, but Hopcraft went down anyway. But Josh, this is genuinely very close still. Nice uppercut there from Chowdhury. As I said, it's not a pretty technique. It comes from the waist, but it does land.
And that one knocked the gum shield clear out of the mouth of Jamie Hopcraft. Still coming forward though. Good look of intention on his face.
He will do. He is, as I said to you before, he is a front foot fighter. He likes that pressure cooker environment. He likes coming forward. He likes standing and trading. And they're exchanging very good hard kicks now as well. Hopcraft doubles it up for the first time.
Yeah, I like that he's really ending any combination of the hands with that right kick. Very rhythmic with it now.
It's a drill they should be doing regularly. Left, right, round kick. Left, right, round kick. Hands high, leg low. You drill that on the bags or with your pads, regular as clockwork. It's bread and butter, but it's effective.
Yeah, and we've seen Hopcraft land four or five of those 1-2 right kicks very successfully at the end of this round.
And to be honest with you, that's why I'm going to veer towards the blue corner for this second round. I've got him slightly ahead now. So, third and final round, and although we feel that Hopcraft took that second round, it's still very close. I just feel if he continues with this style and this rhythm, this could be the difference between the two.
Yeah, still pushing forward. A lot of head movement now from Hopcraft.
Nicely timed knee, though, as he came in from Chowdhury.
Chowdhury just taking a bit of a deep breath. Seems to be very measured in his approach, whereas the work rate, I feel, is coming from Hopcraft here.
And this could sway it for the judges under the scoring system. As you can see, he's stalking his man, bringing him down. cutting the range down and working, and that will catch the judge's eye. Although that measured work of Chowdhury, his face hasn't changed. He's never looked under pressure. He is a cool customer.
Yeah, certainly. He's been very methodical himself, but eating a lot of punches, but staying incredibly calm throughout.
And that methodical nature was the problem with that back fist. It was shown too early and was too easy to see.
It was slightly workmanlike, wasn't it?
That was the term I was looking for. And again, picking up what you said in round two, I just think it's the combination work now of Hopcraft that is slowly beginning to take this fight.
Yeah, he's not becoming... He's throwing a lot of the same combinations, but somehow they don't seem predictable. They still seem to be throwing Chowdhury off and landing.
Well, you saw for the first time there, Chowdhury's leg buckled. The first time he felt the full impact. And I think you've summed it up there. He's good at what he does, but there is a workmanlike quality to it that if you felt he could step up in pace or power, he'd be a real danger.
Yeah, I almost think because he doesn't seem to be troubled too much by the shots he is eating, he's happy to eat them. But of course, they're scoring shots. They're doing the damage. They're really taking this fight the way of Jamie Hopcraft.
Yes, and as you said, that another right hand from Hopcraft landed. Although his nose is bleeding, Chowdhury has got through. But it's on the back foot. This is important. It's always defensive moves, and it's that chopping right leg.
Yeah, he's really starting to turn the hip over well with it now. He knows it's working for him. Chowdhury doesn't seem to be doing anything about checking it or stepping off. It's just thudding in over and over again.
Well, when you put it on the end of each combination, you know the range, you know where the man is. It's not going to miss. Just like that, you know he's there.
Oh, lovely slip and over the top with the 1-2 from Hopcraft.
I've been very entertained with this fight. It has been very even and close until I feel the last minute and a half of this fight.
Yeah, I think Hopcraft has just started to pull this away here. Chowdhury still throwing back. Both guys are sitting in the pocket and trading. But the one constantly driving forward is Jamie Hopcraft.
And as I said to you, that's the sort of fight he loves. I knew he would do it for the three rounds. He likes that tempo. He likes that pace. And I think that's the difference. He took Chowdhury out of the comfort zone. The speed and pace, we obviously saw that he likes to fight in. That was taken from him.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has gone all three rounds. And the judges have come down to a decision. They've called it a majority draw. Please put your hands together for both fighters.